Hello, so in this recording I'll be solving three exercises, which is the adding to a hash table where hash we are using the hash coalesce to separate the zones. So we'll do the insertion to search an element, so exercise 7-8, and the last exercise, which is exercise 17, where we delete an element from a hash table. So here we have two separated zones. So we have this hash table, so its size is equal to m, so it contains up to m elements. So, and we have the delimiter here. So the primary zone is between 0 and p minus 1, and whenever there's a collision, I want to find a place in the reserve zone. So we need to write a function to declare this hash table, to create a hash table. So as you remember, if you followed me in the lecture, so in the coalesce hash table we have cells here, and each cell there's two information: there's the data and the link, because we need to link the related elements that they hash the same hashing value. So let me go, and so I have wrote here most of the code. So I will run it first, and then I will write all these functions. So we need to insert an element, to add an element to the hash table. So let's say I would add a. So a will hash the value of index 2. So at the first when first add this element, so we will fill the index 2, and the link obviously would be equal to minus 1. So let's then add aa. So aa will hash also to the same hashing value. It will be equal also to 2. However, 2 is occupied. We need to find a place in the reserve. So 9 is empty. So I will place aa in 9. So the link would be equal to minus 1, and I need to link a to aa. So look well here, link, it was equal to minus 1 and now it's equal to 9, because I need to link that. If I add now triple a, so triple a also, it will hash the same hashing value, which is 2. So I will need to find a place in the reserve zone. So 8 is empty, so I will place aaa in 8. The link, it will be equal to minus 1. However, I need to link all these, so I need to go from 9, and 9 there's one of my descendant, and then I need to link. Look well here, it was equal to minus 1, and here it will be equal to 8. So this is the idea of the adding of coalesce. So now I will add a. So a is already in the hash table, so it will fail and it will add. So next we need to move into the searching of an element. So if I want to search for an element, so it's the same, it's very easy. So if I need to check the hashing of the element. So if, for example, I'm looking for aa, so I will look, so the hashing of a is equal to 2. So in 2 there's some elements, so I need to find in the hierarchy if there's an aa. So I will look, hey, here a is not equal to aa. I will find its descendant at 9. Okay, at 9 there's aa, so aa is found. Let's say I want to search triple a again, it will be found. Suppose that I want to search b, so the hashing of b is equal to 3, and at 3 is empty, so there is no b. So because there's empty, and of course I will not find it elsewhere. So then I need to delete an element. So here's the most difficult part, because if I need to delete, I need to rectify all the links. So let's first start by deleting aa. So if I delete aa, so I need obviously to remove this cell, so I just need to place in the link minus 2. However, if I place minus 2 here, 9 will be deleted, and I will not reach triple A from A. So I need to rectify the link in A. So look well, if I do AA, so the data here, the link is equal to 8, and it will link to the newly the sub-descendant of A. So again, if now I need to delete A, so here's the trick here. If I need to delete A, I cannot leave the original reserve zone here empty, because I will lose all the descendants. So I need to copy one of my descendant to my place. So if I delete A, look well, the data, all the data, it will come here, and the index A, the cell A, would be empty. So if I delete J, for example, it doesn't exist, and it will finish. So this is the idea. It's not that easy. So we will do the insertion, the search for an element, and the deletion of the element. So let's start. So let's skim quickly over the declaration. So we have the size of the hash table, which is equal to m. The p is the reserve zone, the number of elements, or the index. We have here two functions, min and max. Maybe we can use it. So we have here string. So the element here is about 20 characters. And for the hash table, it consists of m entries, and each entry contains two elements, data, which is a string, and a link to its descendant. So the hash function, so you're not responsible of it, it's just a modulo a p. Why p? Because p is the primary zone, so we need a value between 0 and p minus 1 in order to fit the element in the primary zone. So to create a hash table, I just need to place minus 2 in the each cell, each entry, to say that the entry is empty. So I remind you that minus 2, it means empty. Minus 1, it means the end of the link. So this is the end element of the elements having the same hashing value. And if I have a link which is different than minus 2 and minus 1, it means that we are linking all the elements between each others. So to check whether a hash table is empty, I just need to check whether the link is equal to minus 1. So we need to write all these three functions. So I have already wrote the function print table in order to print the hash table, as you have seen. And in the main, I have three parts, which are the tests for adding, searching, and deleting a string. So those are not important. The most important part are these ones. So I need to add an element into a hash table. So first, the easiest part is that I need to find the hashing value of the element that I need to add, and then I will check the cell in the primary zone. So if it's empty, I will add the element and it will be okay. And if it's not empty, I need to find a place in the reserve zone and place the element, if there's place, and link the element. So let's start. So we need V. So V is the hashing value of the element. So I need to find. So if V is empty, so if the cell is empty, so I will call the function empty. So empty, it will take a hash table, which is T here, and V. So if the cell is empty, I just need to add the element. So it's very easy. So I will copy, because I'm using a string, T of V dot data. I will copy the element E, and I will place in the link. So T of V dot link, it will be equal to a minus 1. This is the first element that I can add. And of course, I will return 1. This is the easiest part. So if I reach here, it means that the cell is not empty. So I need to find a place in the reserve zone. But before that, I need to find the last element in this link. So so those the element that has the same hashing value, I need to find the last element. It means that where the link is equal to minus 1. Because at the end, I need to link the newly added element into the last element in the series of these elements. So for that, I will loop till the end of this hierarchy. So T of V dot link. So as long as I didn't reach the last element, so as long as the link is different than minus 1, and of course I didn't find the element, because as you have seen in the example, I have used the same element in order to end the adding. So as long as the strcmp t of v dot data, and I will compare it with e, is different than 0, it means that it's not equal. So I will move to the next cell. So v equal t of v dot link. So at the end, so either I will reach, I will find the element, or t of v dot link is equal to minus 1. So the index v is the last cell. So if strcmp is equal to 0, it means that the elements are equal. I will return 0. Otherwise, so here it means that I have V contains the index of the last element. So here I need to find a place into the reserve zone. So I will start from M minus 1. This is the last element of the array, so the hash table. So I will go back. So as long as R is greater or equal to P, P is the delimiter of the primary zone. And if it's not empty, the cell of R is not empty, I will go back. So as long as we'll start from the end of the hash table and we'll go till the delimiter of the reserve zone, which is P, and as long as it's not empty, I will do R minus minus. So here, either I found a place, an empty cell, or there's no empty cells remaining. So if R is less than P, it means that there's no places, I will return a zero. Otherwise, it means that in R there's an empty place, sorry, and here I can place the element. So in T of R dot data, I will place E, and in T of R dot link, I will place a minus one because it's the end of the elements, and then I need to link the last element to R. So the last element I have already found it, which is equal to V. So T of V dot link, which is was equal to minus one, it will be equal now to R, because we will link V to R, and of course I will end with a return one since it I will add correctly the element. So let me repeat quickly. So first we have calculated the hashing function, the hashing value of the element that I want to add, and if the cell is empty, I will add the element and return one. Otherwise, I need to find a place in the reserve zone. So here we have tried to find a place in the reserve zone. However, so if there's a place, I will place the element. However, I need to link the last element to this element. So I have found the last element that hashes the same hashing value. So I've looped over the link, and as long as the link is different than minus one, I have jumped. And whenever I finished, I have linked the index V, the link in the index V, to the newly created cell. So this is for the insertion of an element into a hash table where we have a coalesced hashing with a separated zone. So let's move now to the searching of an element into a hash table using the same scheme. So obviously, again, I need to search for the element to hash the element and check if the cell is empty or not. So if it's empty, it means that I will not find it elsewhere, I will return 0, and if it's equal to this element, I will return 1. Otherwise, I need to check the links and if I can find this element. So it's very easy here if you already followed me in the adding of an element. So here again, I will find the hashing value of the element E, and if it's empty, if the cell is empty, we have here T and V. Of course, I will return 0 because I will not, there's no need to search elsewhere. So if it's not empty, I'll try to do the strcmp. So if it's equal to 0, it means I have found the element, I will return 1. Otherwise, I need to check the links. So I will copy this. So as long as the link is different than minus one and they are not equal, I will do v.v.link. However, I need to save the element. So there's no need to save the element. So the tt of v.link. So at the end, either I have reached minus one or it's equal. So let's see that. So if strcmp is equal to E, it means not, because equal to 0, I will return 1. Otherwise, I will return a 0. So let me repeat. So we find the hashing value, and then we check if the cell is empty. If it's empty, it means that I will not find the element E elsewhere, so I return 0. If the element E is equal to the cell in the primary zone, I will return 1. Otherwise, I need to follow the link. And as long as we go, either we will reach T of link equal to minus 1, or we will find strcmp E is equal to 0. If it's equal to 0, it means that I have found the element. Otherwise, if I reach the last element, and it means that I didn't find the element here, so I will return a 0. So this is for the so there's no x here, the searching for an element. And let's move now to delete an element into such a hash table. So again here, so if the easiest part here is to delete an element, the last element, because I just need to place a minus 2 and just to rectify the previous link. However, if I delete an element from the primary zone, I need to copy one element from the reserve zone and place it in its place. So let's start. So here we need A, X, V. So again, I need to find the hashing value and we need to try to discuss that. So if already the cell is empty, so obviously the element wouldn't be in the table, so I will return 0. Here I will need to check. So there is two parts. So first, if the element is in the reserve zone, in the primary zone, sorry, so I need to delete the element and find it's descended and place it in its place. So I need to find an element from the reserve zone. It's descended and place it in its place. If it has a reserve, if it has a descended, if it doesn't have a descendant, though, so I just need to place minus 2. So let's start. So if I found the element in the primary zone, so if t of d dot data is equal to 0, it means that I have found the element. Now I need to check if it has a descendant or not. So if it doesn't have a descendant, if does it mean if t of v dot link is equal to minus 1, so it doesn't have a descendant, I just need to delete it. So I placed in link minus 2. Otherwise, so here it means that it has a descendant. I need to find the descendant and I copy this. So I will place in x t of v dot link. So this is the index of its descendant. And then I'll copy in t of v t of x. So as if I'm writing here t of v equal t of v dot link. So I'm copy all the cell. It means the element, the data, and the link. And then I need to place in t of x dot link, I should place minus 2 because now the cell would be deleted. In both cases here, I will return 1. So this is the part where we copy and an element from the reserve if it exists, if the original element has a descendant. So if the I'm deleting an element that is not the one that is in the primary zone, I need to look for it in the reserve zone. Maybe the element doesn't exist. So if it exists, I will need to search for it first. So for that, of course, I will loop over the remaining of the elements. So we've already done that. So t of v dot link, as long as it's different than minus 1, and I'm searching for str c and p of t of v dot data and e, as long as it doesn't equal to each other, I will move one step forward. However, here I need to keep track of the last cell because I will link it to the next one. So for that, I'm using x equal to v. So I'm saving in x the last, the one before last element, and then in v I will move to the next link. So as if you are doing that in a linked list, if you want to delete an element, you need to place a pointer to the cell that before it. So this is the same idea. I'm just having a pointer, an element. I'm saving the index of the last before element. So when I'm here, so if I found the element, it means, or if I don't find the element, it's better. So I will return 0 because there is nothing to delete. So it means I will return 0. Otherwise, I will just need to link the element. So in t of x, this is the last. So this is not the element I want to delete. This is the parent of the last, the element that I want to delete. So in the link here, I need to modify it because it links to v. So I will link it to the link of v. And then in v, I will say that it's now a deleted cell. And I will return 1. And this is it for the deleting for an element in the coalesce. Let me repeat quickly. So we have the element E. We calculate the hashing function of the element. And if the cell of this hashing value is empty, it means that the element doesn't exist and I cannot delete. So I will return 0. If it's equal to that element, I need to check if it has a descendant. So if it doesn't have a descendant, so I just mark it as deleted. Otherwise, I need to copy the element, its descendant, as it is to its place in V, and I just need to place in T of X, I should mark it as empty. Otherwise, I need to check if the element exists. So I'll check. So I'll check the links, and if the element doesn't exist, I return 0. Meanwhile, I'm saving the last before index, the parent of this element that I want to delete, and I will rectify the links. And this is it. So let me again rerun this program. So let's start. I've added A and then AA. So yes, there's a link which works correctly. Triple A, so 9, it will go to 9 and go to 8. And let's enter A, so in A it will fail. And then we need to search for an element. Let's say triple A. So okay, it's found. Let's enter D, it will not found. And then we need to delete an element. So let's delete a triple A, for example. So look well here, we have minus 1. Let me delete AA. So now I have changed the way I'm deleting the element. And let's delete D, and it will end here. So this is it for this exercise. It's not an easy exercise. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate to write to me, and I will answer you back. And again, thanks for watching.